And so today we'll be examining very briefly the second and last aspect of the series that we have been talking about starting last week, drawing from the life of Martin Luther King. And so last week, Pastor Kaburu shared with us on the fact of being a dreamer, looking at the life of Martin Luther King in honor of Black History Month. And so today is the last part of this series. We'll be talking about the topic, walking out your dream. Walking out your dream. And the reason why we'll be talking about walking out your dream is because it's not just enough to be a dreamer. Many young people, when they are young, they have a lot of dreams and aspirations in life. But very few are those that stick with it and have it fulfilled and realized in their lives. And so as we'll be examining the text before us, can you help me move the slides? We'll be talking about walking out your dream and the reason why this text or this subject is pertinent to us is because dreams on their own don't get fulfilled. Dreams don't work unless you walk it out. Dreams don't work unless you do. And so at the outset of our discussion this morning, it's very important that we make a few definitions so that we have unity in understanding. When we talk about the term dreams, we are not just talking about something that happens in your mind, in your thoughts, or in your senses when you are sleeping at night. No. And Pastor Kaburu shared about that last week. So we're not referring to a series of thought images or sensations occurring in your mind while sleeping. That's not what we are referring to when we are talking about dreams. When we are talking about dreams in our context, we are talking about a mental future picture that inspires you, that energizes your mind, that energizes your will, that energizes your emotions and your resources, and causes your life to gravitate in its direction, empowering you to do everything you can to achieve it. It is a mental picture of a desired future state that causes everything in you to gravitate in that direction. Hallelujah. And so, we'll be using the template of a biblical character to go through this topic. And the biblical character that we'll be using this morning is going to be drawn from the life of Joseph.